Hello students, how are you? I hope you people are doing fine. Myself Deepak, and I welcome you on my YouTube channel Deepak Biology Classes. So student, today I am going to talk about the basic topic, that is characteristic of living beings. So this topic is for those students who have just started studying biology, and also for those who want to learn something in biology. So this is the basic topic, which is characteristic of living beings. So this topic we will discuss in some points, which is like the important points, which are the, or we can say, the characteristic of living beings. So all this we will study with some important points. To the stuff, first one is, if we talk about the first point, so it will be a life cycle. Okay, so if we talk about the life cycle, as we all know, this life cycle, it is one of the major characteristic of living beings. Okay, so all living beings follow a definite life cycle, that is, they are born, they grow, they develop, they reproduce, become sentient, and then die. But life continues via reproduction and heredity. Thus, they carry out different life activities in a definite sequence. So this is the first point which I discussed, which is one of the major characteristics of living beings. If we talk about the another characteristics, so it will be a protoplasm. Okay. It will be a protoplasm. So as we all know that it is a physical basis of life. Everyone knows that protoplasm, it is a physical basis of life. Okay, so the real living matter in living beings is protoplasm, which is the physical basis of life. All the vital activities generally take place in the protoplasm. Generally, proteins and several other chemical substances in a definite ratio and proportion constitute the protoplasm, and the life depends upon the stepwise reaction, which generally takes place between these chemicals in a different, or we can say, definite sequence. So this protoplasm is one of the major characteristics of living beings. So we discussed two important characteristics. After that, the next one is cell structure. As we all know that everyone is made up of cell, group of cells. Okay, so cell structure is one of the major characteristic of living beings. So all living organisms are generally made up of one or more structural units, which we call cells. Okay, in cells of all living organisms, protoplasm is enclosed by a protoplasmic membrane. As we all know that protoplasm, it is enclosed by the protoplasmic membrane. In addition to this membrane, in the plant cell is also enclosed by dead cell wall. Okay, so this cell structure is also one of the important characteristic of living beings. Next, if we talk about the next characteristic, so it is metabolism. Okay, so next is metabolism. So in all living organisms, many chemical as well as physical changes are constantly taking place. In these, anabolic processes are constructive and is opposed to this catabolic process. Okay, catabolic process. So catabolic and anabolic, these are the two important processes which comes under metabolism. And these catabolic processes are destructive. Okay, so these catabolic processes are destructive, as we all know. And the another one is anabolic process. Anabolic processes. Okay, so anabolic processes and the catabolic processes. So there will be two processes. One is catabolic, which is destructive processes, and another one is anabolic process. So these two processes comes under metabolism. Okay, so this metabolism is also one of the important characteristic of living beings. If we talk about the next characteristic, so it will be a respiration, because without respiration we can't survive. Okay, so respiration is one of the important characteristic of living beings. And this respiration process, it is continuously taking place. Okay, so this takes place continuously. This takes place continuously. It is not like that if we stop, we can stop this process. We can't stop this process. It is continuously. One, this respiration, and another one, if you talk about, that is heart. Okay, so heart, it also beats continuously, because of that the blood supplies in our body, or we can say the blood moves in our body. So blood, so respiration as well as heart, these two takes place continuously. Okay, so generally what happens in the respiration process, as we all know, that organism usually take up oxygen from the environment. As we all know that oxygen, we required oxygen for respiration and we have to release CO2. So during this process of respiration, we generally take up oxygen from the environment and usually release CO2. And a food material like the carbohydrate, fats and proteins are continuously oxidized in this process with consequent release of energy. Okay, so this respiration process, it is one of the major characteristic of living beings. So if we talk about the next characteristic, it is nutrition. So the next one is nutrition. So what happens in nutrition? So all living organisms required nutrient for the synthesis of their protoplasm. As we discussed already protoplasm, but everyone required nutrient. Okay, so nutrient, they are the very important for the synthesis of their protoplasm, their growth as well as development. Plant, if we talk about the plant, so how the plant absorb nutrient? So plant absorb water and mineral element from the soil. Like if we talk about the plant, so plant, how they absorb nutrient? So from the soil they absorb. Okay, so from the soil they absorb nutrient. But if we talk about the humans, so how we are absorbing nutrient? We are getting the nutrient from the food. And this food may be carbohydrate, or it may be protein, or it may be fat. So generally there are three major sources of food which we are taking. The first one is carbohydrate, second protein, and next fat. So from this we are absorbing the nutrient, and this nutrient we use for getting the energy so that we can do our work. So from these three major parts we are getting the nutrients, or we can get the energy to do our work. So this nutrition, it is one of the major characteristic of living beings. So if we talk about the next one, so the next will be a growth. So as we all know, growth is also one of the major characteristic. So any permanent and irreversible increase in form and volume usually accompanied by increase in dry weight of an organism, which we called growth. Okay, so if you talk about this growth in plant and human, so in plant growth what happened? If you talk about the plant, so plant growth continuously indefinitely. Okay, so in case of plant, growth continues and indefinitely, as we all know. So if you talk about the tree too, you can see that trees, they can grow unlimited. Along with them, their branches also in the soil, they are very wide. Okay, so in case of, if we talk about the plant growth, so growth continues and indefinitely. Where if we talk about the humans, so what happen in humans? That in humans, the growth is not continue. It is not definite. Okay, so in humans, what happen? The growth is limited. Growth is limited. Okay, and it stops after attainment of a definite age. It stops after attainment of a definite age. So what will happen in case of humans? Growth is limited, but there are some exceptions where people are very tall. You people have seen many people, like some people, they are very tall, like more than 7 feet, more than 8 feet. But this is exceptional. Normally, there is a people in the world which are between 5 to 6 inch. So if you talk about the majority, the majority of the people will be fall in between 5 to 6 feet. Okay, in 5 to 6 feet, mostly people. But this also depends on the country wise. Okay, so if we talk about the Japan, their people are like 4 to 5.5 feet. If we talk about India, so here in 5 to 6 feet, which is the optimum like height. If we talk about the German people, so they are 5.5 to 6.5 feet in tall. If we talk about the American, they are also like 5.5 to 6, or we can say 6 to 7 feet tall. So like that, it also depends on the climate-wise as well as country-wise. So this growth is also one of the important factor. So if we talk about the next factor, so the next characteristic will be a reproduction. Okay, next will be a reproduction. So reproduction, all living organism possess the capability to produce offspring of their type. Okay, so in case of humans, like, we are continuously reproducing, and with the evolution of time there are also many mutations taking place, but the process of reproduction is continued. Okay, next, if we talk about the next characteristic, so it will be a movement or motility. Okay, next is what? Movement or motility. So in movement, like, as we all know, if we compare it with plant and animal, then plant, they can't move, they are fixed to their own position. But if we talk about the humans, so humans have the capability to move from one place to another place. Okay, so movement or motility, these are also one of the major characteristic of living beings. Okay, next, if we talk about the next, so the next one will be excretion. Okay, so next will be a excretion. So if we talk about the next characteristic, so it will be a excretion. As we all know that if we compare it with plant and animal, the plant can't excrete. Okay, but other organism, but all living organism, they can excrete. All living organism can excrete. Okay, so these organisms which are living, so they have the capability to excrete from their body the waste product of their metabolism. But in case of plant, they are fixed, so they can't excrete. Okay, next, if we talk about the evolution. So through evolution, species acquire new ways to survive, to obtain and use energy, and to reproduce. Okay, so evolution is also one of the driving factor for the evolution. Okay, so evolution is one of the driving factor through which there will be a changes, continuously changes, or we can say mutation takes place, through which the species are evolving continuously. Okay, so these are some of the important characteristics of living beings. So I discussed almost 11 important characteristics of living beings. So these are the basic video in which you have seen that what are the characteristics of the living beings. So these 11 are the most important characteristics of living beings. So I hope you people like the video. If you like the video, then hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to all, so that you never miss my video. So let's meet in our next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.